CEA is a carcinoma embryogenic antigen. It is a glycoprotein that is secreted into the tip of the epithelial cell in the colon first and then into the lumen. It's a sort of oncofetal protein, meaning that it is physiologically present in the intestines of the fetus and embryonic stages. And pathologically, it is present in the gastrointestinal cancers, predominantly colorectal cancers. Nearly 90% of colorectal cancers, they have elevated CEA levels. However, we can see CEA elevated in some other cancers unrelated to GI also, like in breast cancer, non-small cell lung cancer, and pancreatic cancer and thyroid cancers also. Even in some benign conditions like pancreatitis, cirrhosis, inflammatory bowel disease, we can see the elevated CEA levels. Why we have done this study is because there are some studies both saying that CEA levels correlate with the stage of colorectal cancers, and some studies saying that they will not correlate with the stage of colorectal cancers. So we want to see what is the result in Indian population. So we attempted that study retrospectively. We want to see which hypothesis is correct. So we analyzed our data retrospectively and observed that out of the 166, among the 166 patients studied, the stage increases. As the stage increases, there is a tendency to see more levels of CEA. Like in stage 1 and 2, we have seen CEA levels less than 5. In stage 3 and 4, there is a tendency of CEA having more than 5 nanogram per ml. However, there is no statistical correlation, significant correlation between the CEA and stage. There is a similar study done by Tobdage et al. And Duffy et al. They have similar result. Like they have seen that although there is numerically increasing CEA with increasing stage, there is no statistical correlation. So we cannot definitely conclude anything. Also, they have included one more parameter, that is the differentiation of the tumor. What they have seen that, again, there is no statistical correlation, but they have seen that the CEA levels are less in poorly differentiated and undifferentiated tumors, but they're really high in well-differentiated adenocarcinomas. As they differentiate into poor and poor, they lose the ability to secrete CEA. So to conclude, CEA is not a perfect tumor marker. So this is particularly important for the physicians and in developing countries where they initially do tumor markers and then refer to the oncophysician. So whenever a patient presents with the symptoms, they should be evaluated fully and should not be relied upon CEA levels only, because it is imperfect tumor marker. It is not so sensitive, not really specific. So we have to rely on our clinical examination, history, as well as imaging rather than CEA alone. Even patients who have elevated CEA levels initially and then on follow-up, we should not rely on CEA alone, because these patients who are having baseline CEA levels high, they may lose the cancer. It may lose the capacity to secrete CEA. So when the imaging is showing the gross progression, but still CEA can be normal. So CEA is imperfect biomarker. We should not rely on it completely.